Buonasera e benvenuti alla città Buffalo e tutti persone di Ohio. Welcome. Okay. You are in Buffalo Bill's Mafia territory now, so gotta be a little careful. I wouldn't advertise that you're from that other place. Okay. Today is a day to promise, to stand on the threshold, to take a risk, to say yes, to begin. Today is a day to promise to freely and generously share a faith which makes us delight in the wonders of God's goodness, a hope that colors a sometimes gray future, a love that wishes to embrace the whole world, and a joy that invites us to dance in the sunshine of God's love. We who are the relatives and friends of Alex and Dana, let us in the days, months, and years ahead never hesitate to support them, remember them, believe in them, pray for them, and love them. For the love they share is our greatest assurance that God lives among us. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness pour out your grace on these, your servants, Alex and Dana, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for one another. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. In the course of history, there have been many words written about love and the meaning of love. But for we who are Christians, the most important words are those recorded in the scriptures. Let us listen now to scripture readings that Alex and Dana have picked out for this, their wedding day. And I invite Aunt Luann to come up for our first reading.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Then God said, "Let us make man in our own image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals, and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply, fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on earth." God looked at everything he had made, and he found it very good. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, it is not jealous, it is not pompous, it is not inflated, it is not rude, it does not seek its own interest, it is not quick to temper, and it does not boast over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but it rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Well, today has finally come, right? The culmination of a lot of planning and especially expense, I'm sure, you know, especially when they're long distance planning, you know, makes things a little bit harder to do things. And I think it's a great tribute to both of you that so many of your family and friends have journeyed here from Ohio to celebrate this day with you. Although one of your family members, Alex, I won't say who, one of your family members said that you promised them free life care of health if they came to your wedding. So we'll hold you to that promise. But despite the wonder of today and the excitement of today, rather than dwell on that, I would like to look into the future. Let's say, 25 years from now, you're celebrating your silver wedding anniversary. You know, both of you have done fairly well in your professions. You formed a health conglomerate in Ohio that has enabled you to live life in a comfortable style. Okay? Both sets of triplets have grown up and graduated from college, and one of them just recently moved out of your home. And it was a wonderful party with family and relatives and friends. And it was one of those parties that everybody craved an invitation to because you have quite the reputation as party people in your circle of friends. But the party has come and gone. Everybody has gone home, and now it's just the two of you. And you're sitting in your rather expansive master suite reminiscing about the past 25 years and asking yourself, how is it that our marriage has not just lasted, but has grown and deepened when so many of the people that we know have not been as fortunate? What is it about our relationship that has made us get to this day? And as you're reminiscing, Alex says, I know what it is. He says, remember that priest who did our wedding mass? You know, whatever his name was, the short one wore glasses. He gave us three words of advice on our wedding day. And we've tried to put that into practice. And I think maybe that's the reason why our marriage lasts. And he says, Dana, remember what that first piece of advice was? Guess not. Okay. It's share. Okay. You will obviously today share many things. The well wishes of your relatives and friends who have gathered here, and then later tonight, you will share the wedding presents that you will receive, I'm sure, in abundance. Get that, in abundance. Okay. And the wedding cake will be symbolic of the sharing that must take part in your life. But you must be able to share much more than just that. You must be willing and able to share your hopes, your dreams, your thoughts for the future and what life together will be. If I make one practical suggestion, spend a part of every day just talking and listening to one another. The second thing is that you can share perfectly everything that's going on in your life, your hopes and your dreams. And Alex, you may know everything that Dana is hoping and wishing for the future. And Dana, you may know perfectly all the frustrations that are a part of Alex's life. But unless you care, there will be little desire to do anything about it or to make it better. You see, care is a synonym for love. And love entails giving as well as receiving. I'm sure if you ask your parents, they will tell you that in their marriages, there was a lot more giving than there was receiving. And you've heard the phrase that marriage is a 50-50 proposition. Well, if you're only giving 50% of yourself to this relationship, what are you doing with the other 50%? Sometimes you will have to give not just 50%, but 100 and maybe even times more than 100% of yourself to a relationship to make it grow and to make it deepen. If I make another suggestion, spend some time every single day declaring your love for one another. And finally, be fair. Everything is happiness and bliss now, smiles and joy and well wishes, but you know as well as I know that ain't always going to be so. There will be times in your life where there will be problems and difficulties. There may be disagreements or arguments of one kind or another. And those are the times that your love, if you give in to that hatred and to that ill will, can really suffer and problems. But if you look for a way out, if you look for a way to solve the problems that you face, then your love will grow and deepen with each passing day. And the problems and difficulties that for other people seem to be insurmountable are mere passing occurrences and occasions. A third bit of advice, as the Bible says, never let the sun go down on your anger. Always let the last words of each day be, I love you. So if you share, if you care, and if you're fair, then your love will plunge to a new level and your marriage will be what Christ intends for marriages to be, a living witness and sign, a sacrament of his presence and his love in our lives. So are you ready? Okay. Alex and Dana, you have come together in the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and this community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with with a special sacrament. Christ abundantly blesses this love that binds you, and through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens you so that you, what he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that you may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Alex and Dana, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
Yes.
Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
Yes.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intent and then to enter into the covenant of matrimony, I ask that you join your hands and declare your consent before God and his church. Face each other. Okay. I, Alex, take you, Dana. To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you.
To love you.
And to honor you.
And to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Dana, take you, Alex.
I, Dana, take you, Alex.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
Good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you.
To love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You have declared your sent before God and his church. May the Lord fill you with his grace and fill you both with blessings. May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity. Dana, take and wear this ring.
Dana, take and wear this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Alex, take and wear this ring.
Alex, take and wear this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Okay. Let me give each other a kiss. Congratulations. Did the photographers get that kiss? It wasn't very long of a kiss. I think they need to do it over again. Yeah. That these faithful Christians, Alex and Dana, newly joined in holy matrimony, may always enjoy health and well-being. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That he will bless their covenant as he chose to sanctify marriage at Cana in Galilee. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That they may be granted perfect and faithful love, peace and strength, and that they bear faithful witness in the name of Christian. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That the Christian people may grow in virtue day by day, and that all who are burdened by any need may receive the help of grace from above. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, for those who cannot be here today because of distance, illness, or other reason, and for those who are suffering from pain and illness of any kind, especially cancer, let us pray to the Lord. That the grace of the sacrament will be renewed by the Holy Spirit in all married people here present. Let us pray to the Lord. Graciously pour out upon this husband and wife, O Lord, the spirit of your love, to make them one heart and one soul. so that nothing whatever may divide those you have joined, and no harm come to those you have filled with your blessing. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. You can kneel down. Now I ask Aunt Kathy and Uncle Paul to bring up our offertory gifts. My brothers and sisters, join with me now in prayer that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good, good of all his holy church. Receive in your kindness, Lord, the offerings we bring in gladness before you. And in your fatherly love, watch over those you have joined in a sacramental covenant. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in him you have made a new covenant with your people, so that, as you have redeemed man and woman by the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, so in Christ you may make them partakers of divine nature and joint heirs with him of heavenly glory. In the union of husband and wife, you give a sign of Christ's loving gift of grace, so that the sacrament we celebrate might draw us back more deeply into the wondrous design of your love. And so, with angels and all the saints, we praise you, and without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel or be seated. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit upon these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night before he was to suffer, at the Last Supper, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, giving you thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis our Pope and Michael our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your presence, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Anthony of Padua, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Please stand. Let us now join all of our prayers into one, using the words which Christ has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. My brothers and sisters, let us pray to the Lord for Alex and for Dana, who come to the altar at the beginning of their married life, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, they may always be bound together by love for one another. Holy Father, you formed man in your own image, male and female you created them, so that as husband and wife, united in body and heart, they might fulfill their calling in the world. O God, who to reveal the great design you formed in your love, will that the love of spouse for each other should foreshadow the covenant you graciously made with your people, so that by fulfilling of the sacramental sign, the mystical marriage of Christ with his church might become manifest in the union of husband and wife among your faithful. Graciously stretch out your right hand over these your servants, Alex and Dana, we pray, and pour into their hearts the power of the Holy Spirit. Grant, O Lord, that as they enter upon this sacramental union, they may share with one another the gifts of your love, and by being for each other a sign of your presence, become one heart and one mind. May they also sustain, O Lord, by their deeds, the home they are forming, and prepare their children to become members of your heavenly household by raising them in the way of the gospel. Graciously crown with your blessings your daughter Dana, so that by being a good wife and mother, she may bring warmth to her home with a love that is pure and adore it with welcoming graciousness. Bestow a heavenly blessing also, O Lord, on Alex, your servant, that he may be a worthy, good, and faithful husband and a provident father. Grant, Holy Father, that desiring to approach your table as a couple joined in marriage in your presence, they may one day have the joy of taking part in your great banquet in heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with all of you. Let us greet one another with a sign of peace and of friendship. Peace be with you. Dana, peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. It gives me great pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Alex Beirut.
Thank you. daydream in my head, I'm drifting, swept up in the moment, wishing every now and then we could just pretend that it's just you and me together. We could stay right here forever, nowhere else to be. It's no mystery that you make the sun come out, you make the world spin round. Track of time we're taking, don't care where it goes. We just make the most of every second that we're given. My love for you is never ending, how it's supposed to be. Yeah, I got all I need, 'cause you make the sun come out, you make the world spin round.
On behalf of Dana, Alex, Ron, Dorothy, Jenna, and myself, we'd like to thank everyone for coming here tonight to celebrate such a special day and the union of two beautiful people. For Jenna and I, this journey started in the fall of Dana's sophomore year at John Carroll University. Jenna and I went to Cleveland to pick Dana up for the Christmas break, and we were told a friend wanted to meet Cooper, our dog. Well, you can guess that friend was Alex. Although they weren't officially dating yet, I believe it was a test to get our opinions of her friend. It wasn't long after that they became officially boyfriend and girlfriend. Of course, as a father, I had my doubts of his intentions with my daughter. Being in Buffalo and they in Cleveland, it took a while to really get to know Alex. We didn't see him as much. I remember one time being on a family vacation in Florida, and Alex came down. At that point, they had been dating for a while, but I noticed Alex still would not hold Dana's hand or show affection in front of Jenna or I. I'm not sure if it was fear or respect, but Alex being worried about what we thought was a sign of a respectful young man, and I knew she had found someone special. Jenna and I have always told our kids to find someone who makes you a better person. And I believe that Dana and Alex complement each other by making one another better people. It's hard to give my only daughter away to go and start her own family. But Alex, you now are bound to this family forever. Today I have gained another son. Alex, we love you. Welcome to our family. Now let's raise our glasses and toast to a long, happy, healthy life for Dana and Alex. Salute.
20 years, crazy. Which means I had 20 years of embarrassing stories I could come up here and share with you today. Oh, yeah. Or I could come up here and tell you all how much Dana means to me and how happy I am for her and her new second best friend. And much to her relief, I'm gonna go with the second option. Growing up and going to elementary and high school together, Dana and I had a little bit of an unspoken agreement. I was a good writer, and she was great at math. So naturally, I wrote all her papers, and she did all my math homework. But despite all that writing I did for her, I was really nervous to write this speech. It was no longer a 7-page essay examining poetry or recapping of Mice and Men. It kind of felt like the most important thing I'd ever written for. For those who don't know, I actually got married about 2 months ago now. I cannot tell you how fun it has been to plan our wedding side by side, going through the whole process together, and it just seems so fitting since we pretty much spent our entire lives together. That being said, I'm only about 2 months into the whole marriage thing, so I asked myself, what do I really know about marriage? I only have about 8 weeks of material to go on so far, so what kind of wedding speech can I really give? But what I can do is to tell you the story of Dana and Alex the way I remember it. So I actually want to take you guys back to a time before Alex, to senior year of high school, and Dana was really distraught. She had gone on a grand total of one college tour at University of Pittsburgh and fell head over heels. And I was considering two colleges, one in Pittsburgh and one in Cleveland, John Carroll. And Dana's parents asked Dana just to take a tour of John Carroll. Just give it a chance, go to the open house, see if she liked it. And Dana absolutely lost it. I'm talking bald her eyes out, snot on the pillow, a total mess. Just to go to a college open house. Yeah, I lied, I guess there's one embarrassing story in here. So I had been to the school before, but I went with Dana for support, and by the end of the tour, we were sold, done, ready to move in, and as if 12 years of inseparable friendship hadn't been enough, we decided to live together for 4 years. And I think back on that moment, Dana casually mentioned the blonde guy that she met in her sophomore year biology class and how he might come over to our suite before the party tonight. And I have to think she was pretty glad she came to John Carroll. Dana and Alex were inseparable from the moment they began dating. They complemented each other so well, Alex's studiousness rubbing off on Dana and Dana showing Alex how to come out of his shell. I have to admit, I third-wheeled on their life quite a bit in college. I even got to the point of calling myself the puppy at the end of the bed.
There's kind of a running joke from all of us that went to college with Dana and Alex, where Dana would always drink this just horrible gas station vodka called Kamchatka. It's in one of those mastic plastic bottles, you know, with the red label. It's really awful. One day at Halloween, Alex shows up to our house, walks in with his own bottle of Kamchatka, dyed orange, and yells, "Happy Halloween, everyone." I knew then Dana may have met her match. Alex, I truly don't think Dana could have found a better man for her anywhere. You support her TikTok obsessions, her sleeping habits that may have her thinking she fell into a coma, and her ability to never give up on a night out. No, in all seriousness, these two challenge each other and support each other so beautifully that it shows the rest of us how it should be done. Dana has always been the best sister I never had. Throughout her life, she's always been my first call for my highest highs, lowest lows, and everything in between. And anyone lucky enough to be one of Dana's people knows that once you're on Dana's team, she has your back no matter what. Dana, I cannot tell you how lucky I have been to have been number one on your roster until today. And being an essentially an adopted member of the Bartolomeo family for the past 20 years, I can promise the Beiruts that you are truly welcoming the best people into your family. So this is usually where I would tell Alex to take care of Dana, to protect her, but there's never been a doubt in my mind that he'll do just that and more. This has been a hard year for a lot of the people in our lives. Dana, Alex, I, and all of our loved ones have gone through some really tough times recently. And I remember talking to Dana a few months ago and her saying how tough it is to be in such an exciting year of our lives, getting married, starting new lives, and meanwhile everything else seems to be going wrong. But I think that's all the more reason to appreciate these moments, to love the people you're with, to celebrate the happy moments in our lives, and most importantly to Dana and Alex, to dance the night away. So with that being said, I think we'll do just that. So if everyone could just raise a toast to Dana and Alex. Woo!
So I'm gonna go the old-fashioned way here. I'm gonna go paper, so bear with me. I might have to change the pages a little bit. But for those who don't know me, my name is Shane Gray, and Alex and I have been boys since freshman year at Holy Name High School in Cleveland, Ohio. I feel like we have a pretty smart audience in here tonight, minus the Bills fans. go Browns. So with that in mind, I'd like to take a moment to define best friend as according to Webster's Dictionary. A best friend is defined as a person's most desirable or valuable possession or resource. I'll leave the desiring part to Dana, but as for the rest, I think it sums up what Alex is to me. I'm lucky enough to have a younger brother myself, so I can't say that Alex is the brother that I never had. I will say, though, that he is the second brother I never had. This past year has been pretty brutal for my wife and I, health-wise. I mention this only because I thought I knew how close Alex and I already were, but these past few months have really shown how incredible of a human being he is. Switching pages. Alex is always the first one to check in, offer up any help he can, come and visit after work, take days off from work, and is constantly there to listen when I need a sounding board. Words cannot describe how grateful I am to have this gentleman in my life, and I will never forget how good he has been to my family and I. I would be remiss if I didn't mention that Alex is also my barking partner when the Cleveland Browns play on Sunday. You can ask Dana, we actually do bark like wild dogs at the TV. He's also the guy I go to when there's Cavs or Guardians news and is consistently breaking Barstool sports news or drama to me, which makes me think he has an inside source, and he honestly might. Thank you for being you, Al, and I appreciate you being such an integral part of my life. I'd like to take a moment now to talk about the bride, so here's what I know about Dana. The first 3 to 4 times I had an opportunity to meet Dana, I never did because little D was busy frolicking around John Carroll having the time of her life. Honestly, every time I would go to visit Al at school, he would brag about this incredible girl that he was dating. Switching pages. But her and I never crossed paths. For all I knew, Al had an imaginary girlfriend. When I did finally get to meet Dana on what seemed like my 10th visit to Carroll, she was all that Alex had hyped her up to be. She was always down to party, she was super funny, and extremely kind. Safe to say that Dana and I hit it off, and she quickly became one of my closest friends. Although she sips her shots of Jameson rather than throwing them down the hatch, she too has been a godsend to Morgan and I, and we are lucky to have her in our lives. Alex and Dana are the epitome of a perfect couple. They are always smiling, laughing, and having an amazing time whenever I see them together. It makes my heart full to see two of my closest friends have a relationship like they do. Me being married for close to a year now has taught me one thing. It isn't always going to be easy, but it sure as hell is much better when you're doing life with your best friend. You guys are two of the most incredible people I know, and I'm certain that today is the start of a beautiful life together. As an Irishman through and through, I'd like to close with an Irish blessing for the Beiruts. May love and laughter light your days and warm your heart and home. May good and faithful friends be yours wherever you may roam. May peace and plenty bless your world with joy that long endures. May all life's passing seasons bring the best to you and yours. Please raise a glass to a lifetime of happiness for Alex and Dana.
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment and each other's face. So much in love, you're alone in this place, like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one, she told me so. And she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. How could that beautiful woman with you be the same freckle-faced kid that I knew, one that I read all those fairy tales to, and tucked into bed all those nights? And I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of time. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will from the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. Someday you might know what I'm going through, when a miracle smiles up at you. I loved her first.
You guys ready on the count of three here? One, two, three.
Joshua!
And hold your position, hold your position. I made a little special phone call this week, ladies and gentlemen, just for this wedding only, because I know I'm going to be in Buffalo this weekend, and I wanted to make it special for you guys. So all my Buffalo Bills fans, this is for you.
Hi, Alex and Dana. Congratulations.
congratulations on the wedding. I know you guys are gonna have a great time with DJ Smooth. He is the man. Congrats again, and turn it up.
Big shout to number 200 right there, the sack leader, Hall of Famer Bruce Smith, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you guys, and at this time, if you guys can clear the dance floor, I got something coming up for Alex and his mother next. Let's go, let's go.